In this figure, we're looking at the gross anatomy of the female reproductive tract. And so we've got really two portions to this figure. Let's start on this side and then we'll come back and look at part A. So we start with the female gonad, which are the ovaries. Males have two testes, females typically have two ovaries. So this is where we're going to see the release of gametes produced via meiosis, and those are oocytes, and we'll talk more about those later. So at ovulation, an oocyte or an egg, we could use that term, is released and moves into what's called the fallopian tubes. And the fallopian tubes carry that gamete to the uterus for possible implantation. The fimbria are finger-like projections on the end of the fallopian tube that drape over the surface of the ovary and help guide the ovulated egg into the fallopian tube. It's in the fallopian tube where fertilization will occur if it's going to happen. So remember, sperm will be deposited in the vagina. The sperm have to move through the cervix into the uterus, and then the sperm will move up the fallopian tubes. Now, human females typically ovulate one egg, and it will switch back and forth between the two ovaries. So the problem is that a portion of the sperm are going to go down the wrong fallopian tube, and there's not going to be an egg there to fertilize. So the idea is that some sperm should ultimately be able to reach the oocyte while it's in the fallopian tube. Now, in males, we talked about a vasectomy as being male sterilization. In females, you hear the expression, the tubes were tied. That refers specifically to the fallopian tubes, in which a section of the fallopian tubes is removed and the ends are ligated, so that the female will continue to ovulate, but it's not going to be possible, A, for the sperm to reach the oocyte, and it's not going to be possible for the oocyte to reach the uterus, which is the site of implantation. Now, let's switch back over to this figure and notice a couple things here. So we're looking, remember we said the uterus here, this is showing us a side view of the uterus. We're not seeing the ovaries and the fallopian tubes within this. Here we see the cervix, and then from the cervix we see the vagina. Again, this is typically the point of deposition of sperm during ejaculation. The vagina then would lead to the external genitalia, the labium majora and minora, and also the clitoris, which is the analogous structure to the male penis. In development, if a Y chromosome is present in a fertilized egg, then what will happen during embryonic development is the clitoris will develop into the tissue of the penis. In the female, obviously that doesn't happen, and so the analogous structure is referred to as the clitoris. Now, the difference between the male and the female has to do, reproductively, has to do with the urethra. Remember, in males, we said the urethra serves both the reproductive system and the urinary system. In females, you see there's no overlap between the two in the sense of the pathway of the gamete being involved with the urethra itself. So you can see that the bladder will excrete urine through the urethra and out through the opening. One other thing to note, just as a side note, pregnant women will urinate quite frequently. Why is that? Well, if you have a fetus developing within the uterus, this is going to get larger and larger, which is going to exert more and more pressure on the bladder, which means females have to urinate more frequently. So guys, be patient. You've got lots of reasons to be patient when your wife is pregnant, but this is one of them. I mean, physiologically, what's going on in the body is absolutely amazing.